These new officer cadets are the cream of new recruits. Nearly all volunteered to be trained in leadership roles in the expanding PNG Defense Force. They make up part of the 10,000 that are being recruited. While the increase is being commended in light of a booming economy and resource exploration, there are also growing concerns that Papua New Guinea could go down the African route, where large companies influence how a nation's army is being used. Dr. Fabian Pock, the defense minister, was quick to dismiss the concerns. He says the army will be used primarily for nation building.
I mean, defense force will be used not really to quell these problems, but as an agent for development of this country. In the process, as an agent for development, meaning that the government has approved for defense force now to be used in road buildings, in wharf buildings, and many other of these activities.
Papua New Guinea came close to the African scenario when sandline mercenaries were hired to quell the Bougainville uprising. But today, Dr. Pock hasn't ruled out the use of the Defence Force in trouble spots around the country. He says Defence Force deployments could happen if there are problems.
Any security problems that appear within the jurisdictions, they can always take control of the situation and try and control it.
The expansion of the Defence Force comes nearly 20 years after the end of the Bougainville crisis. Back then, the PNGDF had a strength of about 6,000. After the war and after the sandline crisis in 1997, the force was drastically reduced to about 2,000 personnel. Scott Wide, National MTV News, Lae.